Hi, my name is Kaylee. Welcome to Unit Rates. Here we will learn how ratios relate to rates. Let's get started. In the last lesson called Part-Part-Whole Ratios, we talked a lot about how we can write ratios as fractions. Like the ratio of spiders to legs is 1 to 8, which we can write as 1 over 8. There is a special name for writing ratios as fractions. It is called a rate. Let's think about making Rice Krispie Treats. The recipe for Rice Krispie Treats is 1/4 cup melted butter, 4 cups of mini marshmallows, and 5 cups of rice cereal. How would you write the ratio of marshmallows to rice cereal? We can write the ratio as 4 to 5. Or we can write this ratio as a fraction, or like 4 cups over 5 cups. But since the units are the same, both are measured in cups, we can leave the units out and write the rate as 4/5. Remember how important it is to write the order of the numbers in the ratio and the rate. Even when the units are the same, the numbers represent amounts of different items. Always write the numerator as the first item given and the denominator as the second item given. Here in this CK12 simulation, we're going to practice writing ratios as rates when the units are the same. So let's say that we need 4 cups of marshmallows and 6 cups of rice cereal. So that ratio of 4 to 6 gives us a rate of 4/6. Now, what if our marshmallows to rice ratio is 9 to 12? Again, we see our marshmallows. The first number given goes to the numerator, and the second number given for rice cereal goes to the denominator. Great work. For my mom's birthday this year, I'm making her bath salts. The recipe for bath salt is 3 cups of Epsom salt, 1 cup of sea salt, and 10 drops of essential oil. What is the ratio of Epsom salt to sea salt? It is 3 cups to 1 cup. So I can write that ratio as 3 to 1. Now, what is the rate of Epsom salt to sea salt? So now if I want to write this as a rate, remember I'm going to go 3/1. But I can simplify a fraction that has a 1 on the bottom. That is just 3. So then this number represents my rate of Epsom salt to sea salt. But for my mom, I doubled the recipe, so she would have a lot of bath salt. If I double the recipe, what is the ratio of Epsom salt to sea salt? Remember, if I double the recipe, we just double the amounts that we want to use. So I'm going to update my amounts as 6, 2, and 20. So now my ratio of Epsom salt to sea salt is 6 to 2. So what is the rate of Epsom salt to sea salt of my doubled recipe? Again, I'm going to put Epsom salt in my numerator, the first thing that's given, and 2, the sea salt in the denominator. But again, I can simplify this fraction. 2 goes into 6 3 times. So the rate of my doubled recipe stays the same. Why does the rate stay the same? The rate stays the same because 3 to 1 and 6 to 2 are equivalent ratios. In this case, we multiply both sides of the ratio 3 to 1 by 2, and we get the ratio 6 to 2. Equivalent ratios will always have the same rate. But now that we've learned about rates, we're going to talk about a special rate called a unit rate. A unit rate is the amount of one item for every single unit of another item. Sound confusing? Let's go back to our bath salt recipe. When we found the rate of Epsom salt to sea salt, we found the rate to be 3/1, which was saying 3 cups of Epsom salt for every 1 cup of sea salt. Since we're comparing the amount of Epsom salt for every 1 cup of sea salt, this rate is a unit rate. Now let's try a harder example. Here we have a recipe for strawberry banana ice cream. It says 2 cups of strawberries to 3 cups of frozen bananas blended together. What is the ratio of strawberries to bananas? 2 to 3. We can write the rate of strawberries to bananas as 2 cups over 3 cups. But remember, with the same units, we can write this rate without units, and it's just 2/3. But what if at home I only have 1 banana? How many strawberries will I need to use? If I know that the rate when I have 3 cups of bananas is 2/3, but I only have a 1 on the bottom, I essentially need to find the equivalent ratio of 2 to 3 with a 1 in the denominator. So to do that, I'm going to divide the top and the bottom of my 2 to 3 rate by 3. So I'm going to get a 1 on the bottom, and I'm going to get 2/3 on the top. And then if I come over here, I can write my answer. If I have 1 banana, I will use 2/3 cups of strawberries. So now I can write my rate when I have 1 cup of bananas as 2/3/1. But since I have this 1 in the denominator, this rate right here is now the unit rate. Now you know that a unit rate is just a rate with a 1 in the denominator. Great job! Keep learning about rates by playing the game and doing the activities. Have fun, and remember to always be clever! Hey, hey.